Have you ever seen a pond that's covered in a layer of green, slimy muck and wondered, what is that gunk? Is the pond supposed to look like that? And is that even healthy for the wildlife?
Ew!
This isn't slime, it's algae. Believe it or not, we can thank one of the elements that we find in the atmosphere for this algal bloom. Nitrogen. But how does nitrogen get from the atmosphere to a pond? Use what you already know to make a prediction. Just like water and carbon, nitrogen gas from the atmosphere can change forms and cycle through the environment in a process called the nitrogen cycle. By the end of this lesson, you'll learn how nitrogen cycles through the atmosphere, biosphere, geosphere, and hydrosphere. You'll also learn why this cycle is essential for the health of ecosystems and how humans can impact this cycle for better or for worse. Nitrogen is the most abundant gas in the atmosphere. In fact, 78% of the Earth's atmosphere is made of nitrogen gas. Nitrogen in the atmosphere acts as an inert gas. Do you remember the definition of an inert gas? An inert gas stabilizes the atmosphere, preventing more reactive gases like oxygen from combusting. Nitrogen is also a key ingredient needed to build the proteins and DNA found inside all living organisms. This means that nitrogen is not only necessary for the Earth's atmosphere, it is necessary inside every single living organism on the planet, including you. It turns out that nitrogen is kind of a big deal. So how does nitrogen get from the atmosphere into your DNA? That seems like a big leap. You guessed it, through the nitrogen cycle. Let's dive in. Okay, so we know there's tons of nitrogen in the atmosphere. That's amazing. But the nitrogen in the atmosphere exists in the form of nitrogen gas, and most living organisms can't access nitrogen in this state. Living things need nitrogen to survive. So how do they get it if they can't use the nitrogen already in the atmosphere? This brings us to one of the key steps in the nitrogen cycle, nitrogen fixation. This is the first step in moving nitrogen from the atmosphere to the biosphere. This big step is actually accomplished by some of the tiniest organisms in our ecosystem. Bacteria. Let's dive into the critical process of nitrogen fixation. First, nitrogen enters the geosphere through soil, either as nitrogen gas diffusing from the atmosphere into the soil, as precipitation from clouds, or as waste products from living organisms. Bacteria in the soil or in the roots of plants take in this nitrogen and convert it into new forms, ammonia, or ammonium, through the process of nitrogen fixation. Other bacteria in the soil can then take this new form of nitrogen and perform a process called nitrification, which turns ammonia and ammonium into nitrates and nitrites. In this new form, plant roots can absorb nitrogen for their own use in a process called assimilation. Additionally, when a consumer eats this plant, it is also getting the nitrogen it needs. This nitrogen can continue to move up throughout the food web, ensuring that all living organisms have the nitrogen they need in a usable form. As plants and animals die, decomposers break down their bodies and return the nitrogen back to the soil in a process called ammonification. This nitrogen can be recycled. It can be assimilated by plants and cycle through the food web over and over again. Whoa, that's a lot of big words. Let's back up and remember the big picture. Tiny bacteria are the big lifters of the nitrogen cycle. These bacteria help take nitrogen gas from the atmosphere and convert it into new forms that all other organisms in the ecosystem can use. This means that we have bacteria to thank for getting the nitrogen we need to build our DNA and proteins, which are essential for all life. This is a cycle. So how does nitrogen get back to the atmosphere? Well, you guessed it, more bacteria. These bacteria help with a process called denitrification, which converts nitrates and nitrites back into nitrogen gas. Nitrogen can also return to the atmosphere from the geosphere. Weathering, erosion, and volcanic eruptions can all help release nitrogen back into the air. Remember, this is a cycle. We've walked through one possible pathway nitrogen could take, but this nitrogen can move in many different directions. Sometimes lightning can help perform nitrogen fixation. Occasionally, ammonia doesn't get converted into nitrates or nitrites right away. In a cycle, the arrows can move in many different directions. This is great because it means our ecosystem can be flexible and responsive, using and changing nitrogen into new forms as needed. Because of this super important cycle, ecosystems in the biosphere thrive. Nitrogen gets to all of the living members of the ecosystem so they can build essential molecules. The non-living soil has nitrogen on hand, and the atmosphere also gets plenty of nitrogen gas. Everybody wins! The nitrogen in the ecosystem is perfectly balanced. But we all know that humans can impact ecosystems and their normal processes, for better or for worse. Just like in the carbon cycle, human activities can introduce stored nitrogen into new parts of the environment. When fossil fuels are burned, some nitrous oxide gas is released into the atmosphere. Additionally, farmers introduce fertilizers containing nitrogen into the soil to increase the number of crops they can grow. What kind of impact do you think these actions have on the nitrogen cycle? Will adding nitrogen to the environment be beneficial or detrimental to living things? How does this impact surrounding ecosystems? Pause the video here to record your predictions. When fossil fuels are burned, the extra nitrogen gas doesn't just stay in the atmosphere. This nitrogen can enter the geosphere through nitrogen fixation and then move into the biosphere, impacting the balance of ecosystems. This balance can also be disturbed by fertilizers in the geosphere. When it rains, excess fertilizers can run off into nearby bodies of water and accumulate. Nitrogen is only good for ecosystems when it is balanced, and adding too much can be harmful. While nitrogen is naturally found in water in small amounts, if too much nitrogen gets into the water, water plants like algae have an excess amount of this nutrient and grow like crazy. This seems great for these plants like algae, right? But what about the rest of the ecosystem? This uncontrolled growth is called eutrophication and creates that slimy-looking layer of algae on top of the water. Not only does this look kind of gross, but this increase in algae and other surface producers can throw off the health of the aquatic ecosystem. This layer of algae can block light from reaching underwater and use up too much oxygen, killing fish and other members of the ecosystem. Increasing the number of producers also throws off the balance of the food web. Remember, matter cannot be created or destroyed, so once this nitrogen enters an ecosystem, it can cycle and change forms, but it doesn't disappear. This is why it's so important for humans to be aware of these key nutrient cycles and to make sure we don't throw off the balance. Let's review the big picture. As we went through the lesson today, we learned that nitrogen from the atmosphere changes forms and moves through the geosphere, biosphere, and hydrosphere in a process called the nitrogen cycle. This nitrogen is critical for living organisms to make molecules like DNA and proteins, and it's an important gas in the Earth's non-living atmosphere. Bacteria play a key role in converting nitrogen gas from the atmosphere into a form that living organisms can use, and recycling nitrogen back into the atmosphere as needed. We looked at one possible pathway in the nitrogen cycle, but remember, there are lots of possible pathways nitrogen could take as it moves through the environment in different forms. It all depends on what the ecosystem needs to be healthy. All of the spheres of environmental science are connected, so nitrogen doesn't just stay in one place. Humans need to be careful about activities that can add too much nitrogen into the air or soil. Disturbing the balance of this important element can be dangerous. So, the next time you see that pond covered in green algae, you'll be reminded that you're looking at a tiny piece of the nitrogen cycle. And you'll know that the atmosphere, geosphere, hydrosphere, and biosphere are all connected in a delicate balance. You can help keep our environment balanced and healthy, so keep learning and exploring. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.